I guess. So I'm gonna ask the burning question first. Why John Wick? Just why in general?
It had to be done.
Yeah.
Did it?
It begged to get done.
We wanted to, we were looking at projects to direct for a long time, and we wanted to find something that was fun, that you could go on a ride, and we could do crazy choreography, and didn't take itself too seriously. And, this lended itself to it. You know, it still has a heart, but at the same time, the world allows us to just do
it. It opens some doors for us, yeah.
Yeah.
And on top of that, through all the different opportunities we've had to kind of jump into the first unit world, I mean, this was brought to us by somebody we work with a ton, someone we totally respect, someone we actually have a relationship with. I mean, Keanu Reeves. I mean, of all the people we've worked with, I mean, he's definitely in the top few percent of hardest working, willing to put in the extra effort, and having just done a directorial debut himself, he kind of got it. So he ended up being not just a cast member, but an ally and a fellow filmmaker. And if you can go in with that kind of partnership, we considered that, well, let's see, we got this really twisted and trippy kind of script. Right. We've got an opportunity to open up some of our action world. But at the same time, like Dave said, we could actually have a heart, have a story, have fun, and do cool action with a cast member that not only do we believe in, we have a relationship with, and he's another filmmaker. So no, I mean, no brainer, man.
Oh, and by the way, he's a movie star.
Yeah,
you might know Keanu Reeves from such films.
That's crazy. First-time directors get the chance to like have a star of his magnitude in your movie.
We actually have a legitimate action movie star. So.
Well, it's not only Keanu though. You also bring in Defoe. You bring in McShane.
Yeah, so not a shabby cast.
Does that make your job easy?
It helps.
Yeah, it doesn't make it worse. I mean, no, it's a little. You definitely get nervous. You're like, wow, this is. We've had a lot of experience with, fairly famous and large stars in our second unit career, but not at this level. And just to have a cast, you look at them, they're allies, they're your support team. And to have Ian McShane, Willem Dafoe, Michael Nyquist, Alfie Allen, Adrian Palicki, Lance Reddick, I mean, it goes on. John Leguizamo, who comes in for a day to do this amazing 14-hour day, and these scenes with Keanu Reeves, who just, I mean, you see these characters jump off the page because of who these people are. I mean, are you kidding? It's...
So what kind of hardships did you guys face going into the first unit world, as you just said? Because you've done so much action work and you have that down pat, but actually being in charge of everything, what challenges does that present?
Well, there were challenges just to get there. I think that there's a perception in Hollywood productions that, second unit guys are, they put the polish on the movie, they shoot the action sequences, but they can't tell a story. So we fought that stigma for a long time. Mm-hmm. John Wick came at the right time as we were trying to really shoot out and do second unit, and like, despite what anybody said, or just do first unit, despite what all the producers say, like, they can't direct. They've never worked with actors. Fact of the matter is, we work with actors every single day on second unit, and as fight choreographers and as stunt coordinators. This was, our chance to prove it. Yeah, and so we really focused on a narrative and a good story.
We say it's a good 50-50. It's a genre film, yes, but it's also got story too. So, I mean, again, we're career oriented. We want to do something different, but at the same time, prove we can do both. I think this is a good balance. Again, we have a full-fledged movie star. We've got a great support cast. We've got a script that lends itself to what we like to do, our background, but at the same time, it also offered the challenge of telling a cool story and keeping people entertained.
So, last question. You guys do an awesome club scene in a place called the Red Circle, and it's a bathhouse kind of club. Number one, is that a real location? Number two, how do I get into that? Do you have to be rushing to get in there?
That one scene had four physical locations. The bathhouse does exist. It's Ayer's Ancient Bath in Soho, in New York City, which is a cool place.
Googling that right now.
Yeah.
It doesn't exist in the context that you saw in the film. It is like a spa.
It's our actual spa. But there was
no champagne and no champagne.
New York City gave us an amazing, amazing location. If you really dig into New York City, you can find some amazing spots. We just thank the people there for being so understanding and putting up with us for the week we had to shoot there. But our DP, Jonathan Sella, gave it its amazing look. The guy can paint an amazing picture, and we thank him every day we watch that movie. But yeah, what we had the
four locations. It was like exterior courthouse was the exterior of the Red Circle. You had the bathhouse was another location. The interior of the club was another location. The bathroom where we kill Victor is location. Another location. So everything,
and just stitched
it's movie
all
magic.
Together.
Yeah. Movie magic.
I think you guys should build clubs after this.
We should design clubs.
But I guess that's a big part of John Wick. We wanted to create a little bit of world that you almost believed. And I think New York City was a great place to do that.
That you'd want to go to.
Yeah, and you want to go to it. So we did a good
I'm
job.
I'm a New Yorker, so it's on my list now.
Right on.
You working again?
No, just sorting some stuff out.
Tasker crew, how many? As many as you have.
I thought I let myself in.
People keep asking if I'm back. Yeah, I'm thinking I'm back.
I'm not afraid of John Wick.
How good's your laundry?
No one's that good.
I thought not.